Hello everyone and welcome back. As we are done with structure and organization of a prokaryotic cell, now we are moving towards the structure and organization of a eukaryotic cell. Before discussing the structure of eukaryotic cell that we are going to discuss in detail, let's first go through the differences between prokaryotic and a eukaryotic cell. This is very important topic as many questions are selected from this topic. The major difference between prokaryotic cell and eukaryotic cell. We are starting the differences from genetic material, nucleus, nucleoid. The genetic material of each and every organism is mostly DNA. There are only a few exceptions, that in case of virus, the main genetic material can be RNA, and in majority of viruses, the genetic material is either DNA or RNA. But in case of all other living organisms, the genetic material is present in the form of DNA. But there are some differences between the genetic material of prokaryotic and eukaryotic cell. In case of prokaryotic cell, first difference, there is a single molecule of DNA. We can observe in this slide that in center, DNA is present in the form of loop and it is a single piece of DNA. In case of eukaryotic organism, the DNA is present in the form of multiple units. For example, in case of human being, there are 46 threads of DNA are present, but in case of bacteria, it is a single thread. The second point is DNA is circular, that there is no free end. Circular doesn't mean that it is present in the form of a circle, but if we spread, then it can be present as in the form of a circle, but it is present in the form of a loop. That can be observed in this diagram. It is labeled as nucleoid or DNA. In case of eukaryotic cell, as we discussed that there are multiple DNA, multiple threads, and each and every thread is linear, that their ends are not fused together. So DNA in case of eukaryotic cell is linear. To understand this point, let's discuss the structure of a eukaryotic cell. This is plasma membrane, the surface view, and we are going to enter in cell. Now the different organelles are visible in a eukaryotic cell, and now we are going to enter in nucleus to observe the structure of DNA. The structure visible is nuclear membrane, and we are going to enter the nucleus through nuclear pore, and this is a chromosome, which is a super coiled form of a chromatin fiber, and this is our chromatin fiber, which is still a super coiled form of our DNA. Now exactly here at this point, what we can observe is that DNA, before coiling in the form of a chromatin fiber, there is a particular structure, this orange colored structure. This is a structure formed of protein known as histone protein. So DNA firstly wrapped around histone protein, and then DNA is coiled to form chromatin, and finally chromatin is super coiled to form chromosome, and this chromosome structure is present in case of eukaryotic cell. In case of prokaryotic cell, there are no histone protein present, and thus there is no formation of chromatin fiber and no chromosome formation is also there. So what the point is, DNA is naked, that there are no histone protein, histone proteins are absent, and there is no chromosome, and formation of genetic material is prochromosome, a structure present before presence of chromosome, prochromosome, or it is also known as genophore. Genophore means gene bearing structure, which is not nucleus. The next point is, prokaryotic cell is a single membrane system. As we observed in this structure, that plasma membrane, that particular membrane is present as a single unit around the cell, and there is no other membrane, not even surrounding the genetic material, to form a nucleus. So basically, a prokaryotic cell is a single membrane system, and as there is no membrane around any organelle and no membrane is present around genetic material, so this genetic material, this DNA, which is directly present in cytoplasm without any covering, so there is no well-defined nucleus. So there is a nucleus-like structure, nucleus plus oides, oides means like structure, nucleus plus oides, nucleoid. So genetic material of prokaryotic cell is known as nucleoid, as there is no nucleus. And as we observed in this animation, that in case of eukaryotic cell, it has double membrane system, that there is a plasma membrane and there is membrane for each and every organelle, in case of most organelles. And like other organelles, genetic material is also covered by well-defined double membrane structure, and this result into formation of a distinct structure called nucleus. There is another structure in present in nucleus, that is known as nucleolus. There may be a number of nucleoli present. Nucleolus is singular, nucleoli is plural. In case of prokaryotic cell, no nucleolus-like structure is present. Next point is the cell wall. We have observed cell wall in case of plant cell and in case of fungal cell. In case of prokaryotic cell, that we can observe, there is a second layer. As we discussed in organization of prokaryotic cell, that envelope of prokaryotic cell consists of three layers. The outermost is glycocalyx. And in this structure, glycocalyx is present as a thick membrane known as capsule. And the second layer is cell wall. And the innermost layer is plasma membrane. So cell wall is present in case of bacteria, absent in case of PPLO or mycoplasma. And if cell wall is also present in eukaryotic cell, in case of fungal cell and plant cell, but the difference is that in case of prokaryotic cell, the cell wall is formed of peptidoglycan or murine. In case of eukaryotic cell, the cell wall is formed of cellulose in case of plants, and cell wall is formed of chitin in case of fungal cell. Next point is, as we discussed, that the cytoplasmic organelles, the membrane bound organelles, are present in eukaryotic cell, but they are absent in prokaryotic cell. So like other organelles, mitochondria is also absent, but the function of respiration is crucial to a living structure. So the respiratory enzymes, which are present in eukaryotic cell on the surface of mitochondria, in case of prokaryotic cell, the respiratory enzymes are present on infolding of plasma membrane, and that infolding of plasma membrane is known as mesosome. The plasma membrane given here in orange color. So this structure is mesosome. Next point, the cytoplasm lacks organelles like mitochondria, as we discussed that mitochondria is absent in prokaryotic. Plastids like chloroplast are absent in prokaryotic. Endoplasmic reticulum absent. Golgi apparatus absent, centrosomes absent, vacuoles absent, lysosomes absent, microfilaments, intermediate fiber and microtubules, all part of cytoskeleton are absent in prokaryotic cell, where eukaryotic cell contain all these organelles, mitochondria present, plastid present, endoplasmic reticulum present, Golgi apparatus present, centrosome present, vacuoles, lysosome, microfilament, intermediate fiber, microtubules, all cytoskeleton structure. These organelles are present in a eukaryotic cell. Next point is vacuoles. Sap vacuole are absent. Gas vacuole may be present. Sap vacuole are common in eukaryotic cell. As we talked about the organelles, that most of the organelles are absent in prokaryotic cell, but ribosomes are present in a prokaryotic cell. But these ribosomes are small. They are measured in Swedberg's unit, and the size of ribosome of a prokaryotic cell is 70S. S is for Swedberg's unit. In case of eukaryotic cell, ribosomes are 80S and are present freely in cytoplasm. Some are present over the surface of nuclear envelope and rough endoplasmic reticulum. Sometime a question is asked many times which type of ribosomes are present in eukaryotic cell. It is very important to note that the 70S ribosome, which are present in prokaryotic cell, the same 70S ribosome are also present in plastid, means chloroplast. And in case of mitochondria, the ribosomes 70S ribosome are also present. So in case of eukaryotic cell, we are having 80S ribosomes in cytoplasm on nuclear envelope and present over the surface of rough endoplasmic reticulum. And in case of eukaryotic cell, the presence of 70S chromosome is also there in case of plastid, chloroplast and mitochondria. And in case of prokaryotic, only 70S ribosomes are present. No 80S ribosomes are there. Endocytosis, including phagocytosis and pinocytosis, and exocytosis are absent. The large substances which cannot cross the plasma membrane are ingested or taken in by cell by the process known as endocytosis. Whenever food particle or other substance come in contact of a cell, plasma membrane surrounds it and then ingest it. This process of ingesting substance is known as endocytosis, which is of two type, phagocytosis and pinocytosis. If the ingested substance are present in form of a solid particle like bacterium, then the process is known as phagocytosis. But if the substance that are being taken, if they are present in form of a liquid, then the process is known as pinocytosis. The next point is cyclosis. Continuous streaming of cytoplasm in eukaryotic cell is known as cyclosis, which is absent in prokaryotic cell. Formation of DNA from DNA is known as replication, and formation of RNA from DNA is known as transcription, and then formation of protein from RNA is known as translation. Firstly, if we are talking about replication, replication is process of formation of DNA from DNA, and DNA in case of eukaryotic cell is present in nucleus. So obviously the process of replication takes place in nucleus in case of eukaryotic cell. Transcription, formation of RNA from DNA. As DNA again present in nucleus, and again the process of transcription takes place in nucleus of eukaryotic cell. In case of prokaryotic cell, the genetic material DNA is directly present in cytoplasm as there is no nucleus. So DNA is present in cytoplasm. So the process of replication, formation of DNA from DNA takes place in cytoplasm. Again, transcription is formation of RNA from DNA. And in case of prokaryotic cell, as there is no nucleus and DNA is directly present in cytoplasm, so transcription takes place in cytoplasm. We can observe the structure, tail-like structure in case of bacterial cell. This is known as flagella, singular flagellum. Flagella is also present in some eukaryotic cell. In case of prokaryotic cell, the flagella is formed of a protein known as flagellin, and it is present as a bundle in no definite pattern. In case of eukaryotic cell, flagella is present in 9+2 pattern and is made up of protein tubulin. There is another structure, an extra copy of DNA in case of bacteria. Here we can observe it, plasmid. Plasmid is additional DNA, additional segment of DNA present in case of prokaryotic cell, which is absent in eukaryotic cell. Spindle apparatus is not formed in cell division and cell divide by a mitosis. In case of prokaryotic cell, nucleus simple divide by constrictions and there is no formation of spindle or thread-like structure. In case of eukaryotic cell, we can observe that there is formation of spindle fibers, and the fibers, also known as thread, are the word mitosis used for that. So cell division is mitosis. So the last point, some prokaryotic cell can perform nitrogen fixation. You must have heard about nitrogen fixation by rhizobium. You can take a hint from that. Rhizobium is a bacterium, and only prokaryotic cell can fix nitrogen. Rhizobium is present in nodes of root nodules of leguminous plant. Leguminous plants cannot fix nitrogen, but they absorb nitrogen from prokaryotic cells that are rhizobium bacteria. And nitrogen fixation is completely absent from eukaryotic cell. So these were some major differences between prokaryotic and eukaryotic cell. And in next video, we will deal with the structure of eukaryotic cell and hope we can add more differences by comparing the organization of eukaryotic cell and prokaryotic cell. During that video, we can note down the difference and we can add those differences into this section. Thank you.